How many times have you or your customers been frustrated by some intermittent connectivity issue that always seemed to resolve itself by the time the issue was reported and made its way to the network operations team for resolution? As someone who's had to troubleshoot issues like this knows, getting or giving a response, while it seems to be working now, has never left anyone with any confidence that the problem was resolved. In this demo vignette, we show how a service outage due to a network failure can be identified and acted upon without having to connect to the CLI of any router, thus speeding up the resolution of the problem. What's the first thing we do when someone says they can't reach so-and-so's website or their connection to the mail server isn't responding? Well, usually we ping or try to trace a path from that user's location to the location of the service being accessed. So that's what we'll do, but we'll do it on a network map. I'll go ahead and log into the web UI of the Route Explorer product, which automatically brings up a map of the network currently being monitored. Once the map finishes loading, the first thing we do is see if there are any glaring issues with the connections to any of the devices. This is just a sanity check and is almost done unconsciously. Any severe problems like routers being down or links being down would show up in red on the map. Right now, I don't immediately notice any connectivity issues in the network. So now I'll go ahead and see if the user currently can reach the services, website, or mail server that they were having trouble reaching earlier. I'm going to use the path highlighting capability of the web map and type in a starting point where the person lives or works near the Seattle router CEAPE114. I'll then type in the address of the server that is providing web, mail, or some other resources for the user. This address is 10.68.22.15. So right away, we see that the server is reachable, and the outage truly is a temporary outage. So that means we have to dig a little deeper to confirm the outage, so we'll now look for any routing events that are specific to just the network of this server. If we don't see anything wrong with the network, then we can have the operators of the server check on it for issues. I'll go ahead and bring up the events details over the last day for the 10.68.22.0 network. I can see that there have been periodic outages, and I can get a sense for the frequency and duration by concentrating on just the events showing the outage. I can see that whatever is causing the outage started around 3 a.m. and is intermittently failing, but seems to be getting worse since the frequency of the occurrences is increasing. This is starting to look like some sort of aging equipment failure, perhaps a loose or strained cable on the verge of permanent failure. To get a sense for how this might be affecting the path to this server, I can go back in time to when the failure started and watch what happens to the path. By playing forward in 1 minute increments, I can see why the user was saying they could access the server some of the time and not at other times. Notice that the path doesn't go away completely, but switches to the West Coast Internet exit point. To discover why this is happening, I can stop the playback and drill into the path to look at contextual information for the current path. This brings up a window with the path isolated to just the relevant routers, shows the hop-by-hop path, and also performance metrics for the routers involved to help detect whether the problem is related to hardware-specific elements. Notice the path is now being resolved by the default route 0.0.0.0/0, meaning that no other path to the server's network exists. This actually tells me that both the primary and backup paths to the network are down, and not just a server interface, so whatever the cause, it apparently is only affecting the switch for that network. If we now go ahead and continue to play this forward, we see that the path continues to fluctuate for about 30 minutes and then becomes stable. One of the nice features with this method is I've been able to verify the problem without having to know any CLI commands or different router vendors' debug methods to prove the issue. I also don't have to go through screens of router logs to find precise moments where the trouble started happening or how severe the problem was. Does this make sense? Can you see how this approach to isolating outages can speed up the process of fixing this type of network failure?